गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस सेशन इज फॉर क्लास 12th. स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द बार मैग्नेट, देन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बार मैग्नेट, आफ्टर दैट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल एंड इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल. आफ्टर दैट वी कंप्लीटेड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल. ओके, so let's see, you can see the topic on the screen. Okay, let's see what is the magnetic dipole. So you can see here, a magnetic dipole consists of two unlike poles of equal strength and separated by small distance. Okay, so it is actually the combination of two unlike poles of equal strength and separated by small distance. Similar like the electric dipole, but it is difference. Sorry, there is one difference, that we cannot separate these two poles. But in case of electric dipole, we can separate the two charges. Okay. For example, a bar magnet जो होती है वो magnetic dipole का example है. A compass needle, etc. are magnetic dipoles. You can write the current carrying loop, it is also an example of magnetic dipole. We shall show that a current loop behaves as a magnetic dipole. An atom of a magnetic material behaves as a dipole due to electrons revolving around the nucleus. So we have already discussed this topic and the Bohr magnetron and the gyro magnetic ratio in the last chapter. So I hope you have the basic idea about these things which is mentioned here, that is, an atom of magnetic material behaves as a dipole due to electrons revolving around the nucleus. Okay, you can see that the two poles of magnetic dipole or a magnet called north pole and south pole are always of equal strength and of opposite nature. तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं जो दो पोल होते हैं, द टू पोल्स ऑफ मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल और अ मैग्नेट कॉल्ड नॉर्थ पोल एंड साउथ पोल आर ऑलवेज ऑफ इक्वल स्ट्रेंथ एंड ऑफ अपोजिट नेचर. फर्दर, सच टू मैग्नेटिक पोल्स एग्जिस्ट ऑलवेज इन पेयर एंड कैन नॉट बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर. तो आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कि ये जो दो पोल होते हैं ये ऑलवेज पेयर में होते हैं और ये कभी भी सेपरेट नहीं किए जा सकते हैं. तो ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. फर्दर, सच टू मैग्नेटिक पोल्स एग्जिस्ट ऑलवेज इन पेयर एंड कैन नॉट बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू पोल्स ऑफ बार मैग्नेट इज कॉल्ड द मैग्नेटिक लेंथ. तो यहाँ पे पोल्स के बीच की जो डिस्टेंस है उसको मैग्नेटिक लेंथ बोल रहे हैं ऑफ द मैग्नेट. एंड इट इज अ वेक्टर डायरेक्टेड फ्रॉम साउथ पोल ऑफ मैग्नेट टू द नॉर्थ पोल. So this is a vector quantity and it is directed from south to north. Similar as in case of the electric vector, the direction was from negative to positive charge and is represented by 2L. This distance is taken as 2L. Magnetic dipole moment is the product of the strength of either pole and the magnetic length 2L of the magnet, and it is represented by M. So it is magnetic dipole moment is equal to strength of either pole into the magnetic length. So you can see M is equal to M into 2L. Okay. Now the magnetic dipole moment is a vector quantity directed from south to north pole of the magnet as shown in the figure. So you can see here, this is the dipole moment. Students, for a current carrying loop, you know the magnetic dipole moment is given by M is equal to current flowing through the loop into area of loop. So this was the formula for current carrying loop which behaves like a dipole, but this one is the formula for magnetic dipole moment for a bar magnet. Okay, so this is true for bar magnet, this is true for current carrying loop. So you can use the formula and find out the magnetic moment in different cases by using the formula फॉर बार मैग्नेट इफ क्वेश्चन इज फॉर बार मैग्नेट एंड फॉर करेंट कैरिंग लूप इफ क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू द करेंट कैरिंग लूप। Now you can see in this picture there is a bar magnet. You can see this south pole, this one is the north pole. Okay, now the distance between south to north pole is taken as 2L. Okay, and you can see the pole strength of both of the pole are equal, and that is M. So the product of this M to with 2L is defined as the magnetic dipole moment, that is capital M. And its direction is from south pole to north pole. We shall show that the SI unit of M is joule per tesla or ampere meter square. So unit जो इसकी है, जो ये magnetic dipole moment है, इसकी unit joule per tesla or ampere meter square हो सकती है। तो यहाँ पे according to requirement आप लिख सकते हैं। और आप एक चीज़ remember रखेंगे, the unit of pole strength is ampere meter. So ये बहुत ही important है। ठीक है। नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज बार मैग्नेट एज एन इक्विवेलेंट सोलेनॉइड। सो स्टूडेंट्स, जो बार मैग्नेट है उसको हम सोलेनॉइड के इक्विवेलेंट दिखा सकते हैं। हमने प्रीवियस क्लास में बार मैग्नेट और सोलेनॉइड के जो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस की ज्योमेट्री है वो भी वहां पर रिप्रेजेंट किया है। तो वहाँ पे भी आपने देखा है कैसे बार मैग्नेट जो है वो सोलेनॉइड के इक्विवेलेंट दिखती है मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस के अकॉर्डिंग। अब यहाँ पे हम लोग मैथमेटिकली इसको देखेंगे कैसे बार मैग्नेट जो है वो सोलेनॉइड के इक्विवेलेंट है। सो लेट्स सी, वी नो दैट अ सर्कुलर सॉरी वी नो दैट अ करेंट लूप एक्ट्स एज अ मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल। अकॉर्डिंग टू एम्पियर्स हाइपोथिसिस ऑल मैग्नेटिक फिनोमेना कैन बी एक्सप्लेन इन टर्म्स ऑफ सर्कुलेटिंग करेंट। तो यहाँ पे एम्पियर्स की जो हाइपोथिसिस है उसको यहाँ पे यूज़ कर रहे हैं। और हम लोग मानते हैं कि जितने भी मैग्नेटिक फिनोमेना हैं सभी को इसके बेसिस पे एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं। किसके बेसिस पे? सर्कुलेटिंग करेंट के बेसिस पे। ठीक है, इन फिगर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स फॉर अ बार मैग्नेट एंड अ करेंट कैरिंग सोलेनॉइड रिजेंबल वेरी क्लोजली, देयरफॉर अ बार मैग्नेट कैन बी टॉट एज अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ सर्कुलेटिंग करेंट्स इन एनालॉजी विद अ सोलेनॉइड। कटिंग अ बार मैग्नेट इज लाइक कटिंग अ सोलेनॉइड। वी गेट टू स्मॉलर सोलेनॉइड्स विद वीकर मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज and the magnetic field lines remains continuous emerging from one face of one solenoid and the entering into other face of other solenoid. If we were to move a small compass needle in neighborhood of a bar magnet and current carrying solenoid, we would find that the deflection of the needle are similar in both the cases. Okay, so यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि ये जो यहाँ पे एक्सप्लेन किया जा रहा है, इन फिगर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस ऑफ बार मैग्नेट एंड करंट कैरिंग सोलेनॉइड रिसेंबल वेरी क्लोजली, यहाँ पे इन दोनों को दिखाया जाएगा। और यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं द बार मैग्नेट कैन बी टॉट एज लार्ज नंबर ऑफ सर्कुलेटिंग करंट्स इन एनालॉजी विद सोलेनॉइड। तो एक बार मैग्नेट को भी वैसे ही हम लोग इमेजिन कर सकते हैं जैसे कि एक सोलेनॉइड में लार्ज नंबर में करंट सर्कुलेट करती है। कटिंग अ बार मैग्नेट इज लाइक कटिंग सोलेनॉइड, जैसे बार मैग्नेट को कट करेंगे तो वो सोलेनॉइड जैसे कट करेंगे उसके इक्विवेलेंट है। वी गेट टू सिमिलर सोलेनॉइड्स विद वीकर मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी। तो अगर आप किसी सोलेनॉइड को कट करते हैं तो आपको क्या मिलेगी? टू स्मॉलर सोलेनॉइड विद वीकर मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज। ठीक है, द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स रिमेन्स कॉन्टिन्यूअस इमर्जिंग फ्रॉम वन फेस ऑफ द वन सोलेनॉइड एंड एंटरिंग इन टू अदर फेस ऑफ अदर सोलेनॉइड। तो यहाँ पे सेम कंडीशन रहेगी। इफ़ वी वर टू मूव अ स्मॉल कंपास नीडल इन नेबरहुड ऑफ अ बार मैग्नेट एंड करंट कैरिंग सोलेनॉइड, वी वुड फाइंड दैट द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ नीडल आर सिमिलर इन बोथ केसेस। तो यहाँ पे अगर आप एक्सपेरिमेंटली चेक करेंगे बाय यूजिंग कंपस फॉर अ सोलेनॉइड एंड फॉर अ बार मैग्नेट यू विल गेट द सिमिलर डिफ्लेक्शन इन द कंपस नीडल. नाउ यू कैन सी दिस वन इज अ बार मैग्नेट एंड मिडिल पॉइंट लाइज एट द सेंटर. ओके द लेंथ इज टेकन एज 2L. सो L along the positive x-axis and L along negative x-axis. Now this dx is the element of this bar magnet. The radius of the cross section is small a, and we want to find out the magnetic field in axial line, that is at point P from the distance r at the center, or you can say from origin. Okay, so in figure, suppose A is radius of the solenoid, 2L the length of solenoid with center O, N the number of turns per unit length of solenoid, I strength of current passed through the solenoid, so we have to calculate the magnetic field at any point P on the axis of solenoid where OP is taken as R. So consider a small element of thickness dx of the solenoid at a distance x from the center O. So you can write the number of turns in the element is n dx, because n is number of turns per unit length and dx is the thickness of this element. So number of turns in this dx is n dx. Okay. Now using equation, magnitude of magnetic field at P due to this current element is given by. So by using the formula of current formula of magnetic field at any point due to current carrying loop is given by dB is equal to mu naught I a square n dx, this is total number of turns, 2 r minus x square plus a square to the power 3 by 2. This is the formula which we have already derived in previous chapter. Okay, and that the topic was magnetic field at any point on the axis of current carrying loop. Okay, so this formula is already derived in previous chapter. You should check this formula. This is very important formula for board examination. So we are directly using this formula here to find out the magnetic field intensity at point P on the axis of this solenoid. So now you can see if P lies at very large distance from center O, it means R is greater than the radius of the solenoid and R is greater than the dx also, sorry x also. So in this case you can write at the place of R minus x only R square, and then R square is very large as compared to A square, so the final result will be R cube. So it means you can write at the place of r minus x square plus a square to the power 3 by 2 is equal to r cube. So this complete part, that is in bracket, can be replaced by r cube for very large r. So we equation 10 becomes dB is equal to mu naught I a square and dx upon 2 r cube. As range of variation of x is from minus L to L, so since we want to find out the total magnetic field, so we can take the limit x from minus L to plus L. Therefore the magnitude of total magnetic field at P due to current carrying solenoid B is equal to mu naught n I a square by 2 r cube, and integration of this variable term, that is dx, is from minus L to plus L. Okay, so it will be B is equal to mu naught n I a square by 2 r cube integration dx from x is equal to minus L to plus L. So it will be mu naught n I a square by 2 r cube, and finally you will get, after putting the limit, this is 2L, because you will get here L, then minus and minus L. This is the value of integration, so this will be equal to 2L. Okay, सो बी इज इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट एन आई ए स्क्वायर बाई टू आर क्यूब इंटू टू एल, सो इट विल बी म्यू नॉट अपॉन फोर पाई इफ यू मल्टीप्लाइड बाई पाई इन न्यूमिनेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर यू विल गेट म्यू नॉट, सॉरी यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई इन न्यूमिनेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर बाई टू पाई, सो यू विल गेट हियर म्यू नॉट अपॉन फोर पाई, देन टू एन these two is with n and 2l you can see here 2l into 2n into I pi a square upon r cube. Now if m is the magnetic moment of the solenoid, then m is equal to total number of turns into current into area of the cross section. So total magnetic moment of this solenoid is given by n into 2l into I into pi a square. So n into 2l the total turns, because you know that the n is number of turn per unit length, so total number of turn is n into 2l. So this complete, that is 2, sorry, n into 2l into I into pi a square, it becomes the magnetic moment of this solenoid. Then final answer will be b is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2 m by r cube. This is the expression for magnetic field intensity at point P due to solenoid. Now this expression for magnetic field on the axial line of a short bar magnet, and this is the same equation which is for the expression for magnetic field on axial line of short magnet. It means these two equations are equivalent and their magnetic properties are also equivalent to each other. So we can say, thus the axial field of a finite solenoid carrying current is same as that of the bar magnet. Hence, for all practical purposes, a finite solenoid carrying current is equivalent to a bar magnet. So we can use a solenoid at the place of bar magnet, okay, in practical purposes. Now our next topic is potential energy of a magnetic dipole in a magnetic field. So let us discuss about the potential energy. So potential energy of a magnetic dipole in a magnetic field is the energy possessed by the dipole due to its particular position in the field. We already know about the potential energy, but here we are talking about the magnetic potential energy of the magnetic dipole in magnetic field. So this field is this energy defined as the potential energy of magnetic dipole in a magnetic field is the energy possessed by the dipole due to its particular position in the field. When a magnetic dipole of moment m is held at an angle theta with the direction of a uniform magnetic field b, the magnitude of torque acting on dipole is given by tau is equal to mb sine theta. So you can see here, when a magnetic dipole of moment m is held at an angle theta with the direction of uniform magnetic field b, then the magnitude of torque acting on dipole is given by tau is equal to mb sine theta. This formula is also have derived in previous chapter. Students, we have already derived this formula for torque on a current carrying loop in external magnetic field. Here we are going to use direct this formula to derive formula for potential energy. Since when magnetic dipole is placed in external magnetic field, there must be rotational effect on the magnetic dipole because it experiences torque. So we will use the formula for work in case of rotational motion, and that is W is equal to tau d theta. Okay. So for this purpose, we are getting here the magnitude of torque on the magnetic dipole. So this torque tend to align the dipole in the direction of the field. Now work has to be done in rotating the dipole against the action of the torque. This work done is stored in magnetic dipole as the potential energy of the dipole. This is the basic definition of the potential energy, you already know. Now, a small amount of work done in rotating the dipole through a small angle d theta अगेंस्ट द रिस्टोरिंग टार्क इज डी डब्ल्यू. सो दिस डी डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू टाउ डी थीटा. दिस टाउ इज टॉर्क. वी कैन सब्सटीट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ टाउ फ्रॉम इक्वेशन 16 एंड यू विल गेट डी डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू एम बी साइन थीटा इंटू डी थीटा. Now, the total work done in rotating the dipole from the limit theta is equal to theta 1 to theta 2 is given by the integration of the dW, that is W is equal to from theta 1 to theta 2, integration from theta 1 to theta 2, mb sin theta d theta. And you know that the integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. Now, after using the upper and lower limit, you will get this one is minus mb cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. So this is the formula to find out the potential energy of dipole in external magnetic field. I hope you understand this formula. This is very easy derivation. Okay, this type of derivation we have already done in class 11th. The chapter was rotational motion. Okay, so you can find out this work done in rotational motion that is stored in form of magnetic potential energy in magnetic dipole in external magnetic field. So let us discuss about this formula, that is this is the formula and this W is now replaced by U, that is the potential energy. Now when theta is equal to 90 degree and theta 2 is equal to theta, then we will get potential energy is equal to minus mb cos theta minus 90 cos 90. So it is W is equal to minus mb cos theta. In vector notation we may free write the equation 18 as u is equal to minus m dot b, since you know that in scalar product a dot b is equal to a b cos theta, where a and b are magnitude of the vector. So in same way, if this is mb cos theta, you can write it m vector dot b vector. Okay, so the first particular case is when theta is equal to 90 degree, then you get u is equal to 0, the potential energy is 0. So you can see here, when the dipole is perpendicular to the magnetic field, its potential energy is 0. When the dipole is perpendicular to the magnetic field, its potential energy is 0. So now I am sure you are able to understand these things. If magnetic field is like this and the bar magnet is perpendicular to this field, then the potential energy is 0. So when dipole is perpendicular to the magnetic field, its potential energy is 0. Hence, to calculate potential energy of dipole at any position making angle theta with B, we use u is equal to minus mb cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1, and take theta 1 as 90 and theta 2 is theta. So we get u is equal to minus mb cos theta minus cos 90, that is minus mb cos theta. And when theta is equal to 0, you will get this is minus m into b. So which is minimum? Now you can see this is the minimum value of the potential energy. This is the position of stable equilibrium. So equilibrium will be stable at the minimum energy, that is minimum potential energy. When the magnetic dipole is aligning along the magnetic field, it is in stable equilibrium having potential energy minimum. So if this dipole is lying in the same direction of the magnetic field, it will have the minimum amount of potential energy, that is minus mb, and it will be in stable equilibrium. Okay, now when theta is equal to 180 degree, u is equal to positive mb, because cos 180 is minus 1, so you will get u is equal to m into b, which is maximum value. So this is the position of unstable equilibrium. So this one is the position of unstable equilibrium of the dipole. In this case, the dipole is opposite to the direction of external magnetic field. ओके सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्टेबल एंड अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड द केस व्हेन इट विल बी इन स्टेबल एंड अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम. स्टूडेंट द सिमिलर डेरिवेशंस एंड डिस्कशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड इन चैप्टर सेकेंड इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल इन एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. तो सिमिलर केस यू कैन सी हियर. सो यू यू शुड ट्राई टू रिवाइज दीज टू टॉपिक्स टूगेदर सो यू कैन फाइंड आउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू टॉपिक्स एंड यू विल फाइंड आउट द सिमिलैरिटीज एंड इट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट इन मोर डीप वे. ओके सो ट्राई टू स्टडी अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल एंड द मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल टूगेदर एंड यू विल गेट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रिजल्ट्स, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डिफरेंसेज एंड सिमिलैरिटीज बिटवीन देम एंड यू विल गेट द इक्वेशंस दैट आर वेरी सिमिलर टू ईच अदर विथ समथिंग डिफरेंट इन देयर कॉन्स्टेंट एंड द डिफाइंड फिजिकल क्वांटिटी बट देयर स्ट्रक्चर्स आर वेरी सिमिलर टू ईच अदर. ओके एंड यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दीज थिंग्स very easily. So try to do this. Okay, so after completion of this topic we are going to study about the topic that is magnetism and Gauss law. Okay, so student we have already discussed about the electrostatics and Gauss law, or you can say Gauss law of electrostatics. And I hope you remember the statement and you know about that law. Let me revise that law. And according to Gauss law of electrostatics, the total outward flux from a closed surface is equal to the 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed within that surface. It means you can say that the phi e, that is flux, is equal to q by epsilon naught, where q is total charge enclosed by the surface. So that was the Gauss law related to the electrostatics. Now we are going to study the Gauss law for magnetism. So let's see the statement. According to Gauss law of magnetism, the net magnetic flux through any closed surface is always zero. Student, this is very important. This is very important law. So why this happens? So since if you enclose any magnetic material within a closed surface, suppose this one is the bar magnet, okay, and it is enclosed by a surface. So the total outward flux from this closed surface is zero. This is the statement of Gauss law. Now, if you change this bar magnet by solenoid or current carrying loop, the result will be same. So this is the statement of Gauss law for magnetism. Let me repeat the things. Suppose you have a closed surface. Suppose this one is a closed surface. Now if you put here a bar magnet and check the total outward flux, that will be zero. If you replace this bar magnet by solenoid, then again the result is same. And if you replace the current carrying loop, again result is same. This says that according to Gauss law of magnetism, the net magnetic flux through any closed surface is always zero. So this says that for any closed surface, there will be no outward flux from the closed surface in case of magnetism. Why this happens? So the very easy answer for this question is because these all the magnetic materials are always dipole. Okay, so it means it always contains south pole and north pole together. So the total outward flux is equal to total inward flux and the net will be zero. But in case of electrostatics, you can enclose a positive charge only inside the surface, so there will be some resultant electric flux, or you can enclose some negative charge within the enclosed surface, then again there will be some net result. But in case of magnetism, the enclosed, that is the magnetic material which is enclosed by the surface, is always a dipole. Okay, it is always a dipole. It means the total outward flux by the one of the pole is equal to the total inward flux from other pole. So the net outward flux is always zero from the closed surface. So this is the Gauss law of magnetism. I hope you understand this टॉपिक मैथमेटिकली यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस क्लोज इंटीग्रल ऑफ बी दैट इज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ओवर द क्लोज सरफेस दैट इज डी एस इज इक्वल टू जीरो. So this is the Gauss law of magnetism. Okay, I hope you understand this Gauss law of magnetism. Okay. So students, in next session we will start the earth magnetism. Okay, and I hope you understand this concept of Gauss law of magnetism in this session and other topic which we have discussed in this session. So try to solve the numerical problems related to these topics. And you will get the more and more knowledge about the similar topics and you will be able to apply the similar concept in different cases, different questions and different experiments. So thank you for watching this session.